Okay. And there's a lot of information around, if you go searching around on net about cataract. Is it true that you have to look at the weather before you perform the surgery?
So briefly, I had just alluded to you from the point of view of how the surgery was done earlier, etc. So therefore, because the patient had to be immobilized earlier, this I'm talking about decades ago, and there weren't air conditioners and things like that, so it was normally preferred to be done in winter. The second thing was because the incision was larger, and even surgeries were done in railway stations, as I would tell you, cataract surgeries, or they were done in schools or temporary places which are not done anymore, etc. So the chances of infection were much higher when there was hot, humid environment. So therefore, what was a myth, which is now no longer the kind of patients, we still do more patients during the winters because the people, old people still have those myths, but that is shrinking now. Weather has no effect whatsoever on the surgical outcomes because there is no longer immobilization that is required, there is no longer sutures, there is no longer, and most of us have good weather conditions within the house, so there is absolutely no specific indication that you have to wait for this particular season to get the surgery done. It can be done at any time of the year.
And Dr. Sachdev, another fact check, is it true that you have to perform the surgery only when the cataract has matured?
I think this again is a myth that needs to be rectified. We do not wait for the cataract to mature in today's circumstances to do the surgery. The surgery is indicated as and when an individual has difficulty in performing day-to-day activities. Nobody today wants to go bone blind and not be able to see anything and leave one's work, etc., to get the... So basically, if the cataract is totally mature, that means you're not seeing anything.
Okay.
So people are active now, even at 65, 70, 75, they want to do work. So if you are not able to read, write, watch television, drive, etc., whatever is coming in your way in your normal activities, you should go ahead and get your cataract surgery done.
Okay.
Now, why is this concept changed so suddenly? As I told you in the beginning of our discussion was that when a cataract is matured, there are certain zonules which are 360 degree around the cataract which hold the lens in position. As the cataract keeps on maturing, that means it's aging, these zonules also become weak. Okay, so it is very easy to break these zonules. So we were taking out this lens or cataract as a single piece. So therefore, when the cataract matured, you were able to tumble out this entire lens and easily break the zonules without disturbing the back part of the eye, which is the vitreous.
Absolutely.
Okay, so that's what used to happen.
Right.
Now, when we moved on from the earlier surgery to phacoemulsification, where we are also implanting a lens. Earlier, we were not implanting a lens. Now, we are implanting a lens. So if you conceptualize, say, a fruit, let's look at a coconut. So you slice off the top of the coconut, that's like making an opening in the anterior capsule of the lens. The lens is also enveloped by a capsule. So you are making an opening in the interior part of the capsule, going in with a phaco or with a laser, breaking the cataract into small pieces and sucking it out. Now this leaves behind an empty envelope, like you have the outer chilka of a coconut or whatever. So this is going to give you the support for the artificial lens. The artificial lens is now implanted into the same empty envelope that is there. So we want the envelope to be rigidly in place. That means that the zonules need to be strong. And we do not wish the capsule to move out after the lens has been implanted for times to come later on also. So therefore, the situation today is totally reversed. We would like to operate the cataract at an immature stage and keep the capsule intact so that that becomes the support for the artificial lens. The second thing is that as the cataract keeps on maturing, the cataract tends to become harder. It becomes, the proteins become more compact. It could be as hard, say, like a betel nut. So breaking that into small little pieces becomes more difficult. It needs more energy to break that, and that causes collateral damage to the other parts of the eye, that means the cornea, etc. So the recovery becomes slower. Right. So today's world, please get your cataract operated. as and when you are having difficulty in your day-to-day activities. Do not wait for the cataract again. Do not wait for the cataract to mature, because that will be counterproductive both for you in your life, as also your being ability to do things, as also for the surgeon to do a good surgical procedure.
Right. And since you touched upon technology so much, so one hears of this Femto cataract surgery. Is that the most advanced technology that we have available? And where do you see technology in this field going ahead?
So, if you look at technology, the biggest thing in ophthalmology is that there are ways and means by which you can visualize any part of the eye. And because you can visualize any part of the eye, there are ways and means by which you can deliver the light is a powerful source of light of the same frequency, which you are able to deliver on different parts of the eye. So what has happened now is that there is a laser which is called as femtosecond laser. Femto is a quantification of time. And femto, like you have these delivery which is called zepto, this is still faster, so this is called as femto. Femto is 1/4 trillionth of a second.
Okay.
10^-15. So that is the brevity of the pulse. The femtosecond names comes from because this pulse, one pulse of this laser is fired for only 1/4 trillionth of a second. It is a very high intensity, high power pulse, which is able to make openings in the lens, which is able to break the nucleus into small little pieces. It is able to make incisions in the cornea. So that is the femtosecond laser technology. It's called as FLACS, Femto Laser Assisted Cataract Surgery, which is a semi-robotic kind of a surgery where you are first getting an in vivo, that means a real-time image of the cataract. You are getting a real-time image of the cataract of the front part of the eye, and accordingly the machine is putting as to how, where, how much should be cut or how much should be the slicing and how much it is, and that is a semi-robotic surgery which has made it much more perfect, much more precise. Though there is a cost involved, so it has not become the standard of care, but anybody who can afford is going in for those procedures. Majority of my procedures, I would say 70-80% are with femto laser. Yes, it has equalized surgeons, I would say, because the skill set in doing this is slightly less than what you were doing earlier. But then there are 4 critical steps of the cataract surgery which are done by the femto laser.
Follow Center for Sight and post your queries to get answers from the experts.